Hello kids, today we would be doing Python file handling. Let us see how to read and write into a file using Python. There are two type of files that can be used for reading and writing with the help of Python programming. You can either write into a text file or into a binary file. When you are writing in a text file, the contents are stored in ASCII or Unicode characters. In binary, they are stored in machine language, which is the binary language, which is not human readable. In text file, each sentence is ended or each line is ended with end of line, which is slash n new character. Whereas in binary file, since there is no translation happening from low level binary to any higher level languages, which we understand, so the transaction of reading, writing, appending becomes very fast. What are the different operations that we can perform on a file? Reading from a file, writing to a file, or appending data to a file. Now, before creating before using a file for all this reading, writing, and appending, you need to create a file object. What is a file object? File object is a reference to the actual file which exists on your hard disk. Over here you can see that I have created a file object, file1. File1 is a name given to the file object, hence it follows all the rules of identification. Open is the building method, and texas.txt is the file which I want to open to perform some operation on it. Since I have not specified which operation I want to perform on it, whether reading, writing, or appending, by default it is opened in a read mode, means I am only allowed to read from the file. If I want to write to the file, then I need to give it a access mode, which is W means write. Okay, there are different access mode, we'll be discussing it. Okay, if the file texas.txt exists in the same place where I am going to save my python.py file, then I need not give any path. But if this file exists in some other folder, then I need to give the entire path. And if I want to use a slash in its raw format, not as an escape sequence, then I have to write R before it. Here I have not written R, so I have to consider slash as an escape sequence and use slash before it. File1.close will close my file, and then after no operations are performed. This is at the end after I have done my reading, writing, or appending. How can I write into a file? There are two ways I can write. I can use the method write. Write will write a single string it will take as a parameter. This is any string value. str1 can be str1 is equal to hello, how are you, or something is there. It will be written in the file, file1. Okay, the file1 object will write it in texas.txt. Write lines, it will take a list with elements, and then I can write the entire list in the file by write lines. Let us see through an example how we can write in a file. Here I have created a file. I have created file1 is the file object, and I have opened myfile.txt in write mode. Okay, s is a string I have created, and using the function write I am writing the string. Then I am writing to, then I am writing Python world, and I am just printing that done with writing, and I am closing the file. Let us run this. So it is giving me that done with writing. Let us open the file and see. If I open my folder where I have stored python.py, I will open, and I have found myfile.txt. I am opening it in Notepad. You can see contents are written in it, though there was no space specified, so he has just written it in a single line. Now in order that it is written in different lines, I have entered slash n manually behind each and every word so that it would go to the next line. If you will check out, it will give me an output. Now my new text file will be having welcome to Python world. Next, we will see reading from a file. we will be seeing how to read from a file. There are three ways you can read from a file: by the method read, readline, and readlines. When you use the method read, it will read from the first character till the last character of the file and will return you it in the form of string. If I am going to enter any number inside as a parameter or as an argument to the read method, then it will read only that many characters and return. If n is 7, it will read only 7 characters from the file and return it to you in the form of string. It will, if I am saying read 40, it will read 40 characters from the first line to second line and everywhere up till it reaches 40 and return you in the form of a string. In read line, when I try to read a line, when I say only read line, it will read the first line till it reaches end of line slash n and return you in the form of string. If I say read line 7, from the first line he will read 7 characters and return to you. If I say read line 40, it will still read only the first line and return. It will not go to the next line because it is only read line. In case of read lines, it will read each and every line of the file. That is, every line means the one which ends with slash n or end of file, EOF. And it will be made as an element of a list and the list will be returned to you. Now in read lines, if I am going to say 40, then it will read the first line, go to the second line, and up till it reaches 40 character, that many lines he will return to me. But if I say read lines 2, he will read only the first line. Okay, let us see this through examples. Here I have opened the file in read mode and I am trying to use the method read. I have used read method without any parameter or without any arguments. Let us run the, and it is going to show me welcome to Python world. Okay. Now if I am changing this and I am writing 5, that is, I want 5 characters to be read, and I am running it. It is going to read only 5 characters. After 5 characters are read, if I am going to call read again, it will start reading from that particular place. That is, if I am going to write s is equal to file1.read and I am going to say another 5 characters, okay, and I want to print this s, it is going to show me welcome, and then 2 is in next line. It went to the next line and read that part also because it had to read a total 5 characters. Now there is a slash n at the end, which is the new line, end of the line, that is also considered as a character. So it read 1, 2, a new line, and then TO2. Here if I change this and I make it 0, now what will be the output? When the read was executed, it read from the first up till the end of the file. So when I tell him to read again, he will not find anything, and hence there will be no output for the second time. Here he has read it for the second time. He could not find any 5 characters because the pointer of the file had already reached after the read method with empty parentheses. It had reached to the end of the file, that is EOF, and after that when he tried to read, he could not find anything. So there is an empty, no error is thrown, and empty output has been generated. Okay. Now I can change this. How I have used read, and read had made the pointer reach to the end. After that, I can use something known as seek method of file object, file1.seek, and then I have to give the index where it has to reach. I told him that I want to reach to the 0th index, means the first character. Okay. So when I execute this, it read welcome to Python world. The cursor was at the end of the file, but when I told him to reach back to the 0th index, that is the first character, then he after that read the 5 characters and showed me welcome. This is how this works when you use seek. I can seek, say I am already reaching to number 3, and that is I want to start reading from the third character. I want to start reading from the fourth character. Seek 3 means index number 3, and index starts from 0. So when I will run this, it gave me the output welcome to Python world, and then he started reading from COME, which is the fourth, 0, 1, 2 and 3, that is index, and actually the fourth character and index number 3. Clear? Okay. Now let us use read line. It reads one line. Let us see what is the output. It has read one line for us. One line was welcome. You can see the file. In the file, I have not got the file open. Wait, I'll open it for you. This is my file. Welcome is the first line. 2 and Python world is the third line. This is my file. Now let us see that if I am saying read a line, it will give me one line, that is at the end, till the end. Now read line, I will tell him 2. So it will read only 2 characters from the first line. You can see only 2 characters from the first line. Now my first line is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 characters. And I try tell him to read 10 characters. In that case, what is the output it will give me? Still only the first line, because it will not move to the next line even if I give him more than one line characters. But for lines it is different. If I tell him to read lines, first read lines, we will check. Read lines will return a list value for me. Run the module. Okay, it will return me a list with each and every line being, each and every line is the element of the list. So this is how it will give in the case of read lines. But in read lines, I told him to give me 10. So the first value has already been entered in the first list and it spans to the second line. So it will take the first line and it will take the second line also. Clear? If I tell him that I want only one read lines, it will give me the first element, that is the first line. Clear? What if I tell him to give me, say, 20? Okay, so 7, 8, 9 and 20 means it is already going to the third, so he has already completed the last one. In case I am giving him size which is bigger than what is there in the file, it throws no error, but whatever is present in the file, it will show that much to me. Okay, here also you can use a seek, you can go back to the original and then print it over again. Clear? So if I want that, it should go back to the 0th again, and again I want it to read lines and show me, it is going to show me the lines again and will make one more or the same list. Okay, I have an issue with this. You can see when I have done this that I have taken 20, so all the elements were used up in the list. Then I went again to the 0th and again used it. Then again he made the same list again, this time in S. So clear with read line, read and read lines. Many questions will come from this as your practical or as your MCQs in your written test. So be aware how to use them, all of them. Let us see this small code which has been written over here for reading and writing. I have opened a file, my file in a write mode, and I have made a list with three values and slash n indicating that it is a new line. And I have written hello and then return used write lines and returned it. You can see that first hello is written and then this is Delhi, then this is Paris and this is London. This is the output or this is the content in the text file. When we reach here, I have closed the file. One more thing, you can open the file and then you can read as well as write and do everything in the same file in the same Python code without closing it, and later on in the end after all the operations are done you can close it. I'll show you an example for that also. Here I have opened in read mode. I have used read. This is the code we already did. Read lines, read 9 characters, seek 0 going back, read line up till 9 characters, but not read line means it will read up till 9 characters, and even if the first line has less than 9 characters it will not go to the second line, whereas here it can go to second line. Now 2 bytes are used by slash n. It is itself a special character. Okay, these are the different access mode. R is for reading from a file, RB read in binary format, R plus read as well as write, RB plus read as well as write in binary format, W for read, W for write, WB for write in binary format, W plus is write and also read, WB plus means write and read but in binary, A is for append, AB is appending binary format, A plus is append read write, and AB plus append read write in binary format. These are the different modes or the position of the file pointers. When you are opening for reading, the file pointer is always at beginning of the file BOF. Now when you are opening in write mode, again it is always at the beginning of the file. It means if I open a file and write into it and again write into it, then it is existing at the BOF, so it will be overwritten. I'll show you example for this. EOF, when I am appending it, it is written at the end of the file. Okay, this we have already discussed. Read 4 bytes, read 3 bytes and reads all the remaining bytes. Okay, now when it is binary format you can write W plus B, R plus B also, but for read and write you cannot do W plus R. You cannot use something like this. You can use WR or W plus or R plus. Okay, let us see what is next that we are having. Okay, tips for writing a program. I'll explain this with examples. Now here we have already run this code. We know that we have opened a file myfile.txt in write mode and we have written 3 write statements and we have written into this file in one go. Now suppose I am changing the contents and I am making it do come. Okay, I have changed welcome to do come and then I am trying to run this code. The same file I have opened now with little change in the contents. Let us see what is the he is telling done with writing. Let me open the file and show you. You can see that it is overwritten. That is, when I opened the file again in write mode, what it did is that its pointer was waiting at the beginning of the file and I had changed welcome to do come, so it is overwritten on it. Now in case I don't want to overwrite and I am doing appending, that is what this time when I open the file will be appended and the new contents will be written at the end because the pointer will be at the end of the file, not at the beginning of the file. This is the difference between append and write. When you use write, the pointer is at the beginning of the file. When with A, the pointer is at the When you open the file with append, then the pointer is at the end of the file, and with the help of when you write W, the pointer is at the beginning of the file. Let us run this and see what is the content of the file now. I have opened in append mode. Pointer was waiting at the end of the file. Okay. He is telling that he has done writing. I'll open the. You can see when I did it again, then it is appended, means it has been written one more time. Now see, suppose I again move it into write mode and I change all the contents. I want to write something. I have written A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and I am changing all the contents. Let us run and see the code. And it is in write mode, so it will be overwritten. Okay. I am done with writing. Let us open the file and see. You can see it is overwritten. Okay. So the original content, it is overwritten on it, and the other part has already disappeared because the entire file was emptied and then the new contents were written into it. Clear? Okay. Now how can this be changed? This can be changed if I manually change using the seek. Okay, I can use a seek if I want to write after that. Okay, and I can change in one code itself. Let us see an example. Now here you can see what I have done. I have opened the file in reading as well as writing mode. I have read from it first and then printed it, and I have used the function tell. Seek and tell are two opposites. Seek will take to a particular index and tell will tell you where is the file pointer at current point of time. Okay, so I have read. When I use read, it will reach to the end of the file. So it has reached to the end of the file, and when I told him ki tell me where you are, he told me that he is at 29. After that I told him to write certain things and then I closed it. Now this is the output when I ran this file. Let us open the file and see what is the output. You can see that when I read into it, it reached to the end. So the pointer was waiting at the end. So at a 29, right? And then I told him to write. So he wrote it at the end. So this time the writing operation started at the end. So though I have written read and I have not used append, I was able to append because I shifted the pointer. By using the read method, I shifted the pointer to the end of the file and then I used the write method. So I was able to append at the end. So this is how, without using append, you can read and then move the pointer, manipulate it and then write it. Here tell me, gave me answer 29, which indicates that the size of my entire file was 29. So instead of writing these three things, that is reading and this, I can use seek and then I can go to the end. I can use 29, or else what I can do is I will read, then I will find out the length, and then I will say file 1 dot seek length of s. What is s? S is the entire content of the file. Its length I have written and I have kept it over here, and then when I'll run it, then it will be already at the end of the file and then it will be appended. So these are the two ways you can, without using the append mode, using the write and read mode, write into a file. Now there are certain tips that I would give because the type of questions being asked in exam. You are asked to find out how many characters are there in a file. What will I do? I open the file in read mode. I created a variable sum, and what I did is I use the read method. Okay, so I would be using the read method. S is equal to file 1 dot read. It will read all the characters and keep it in the S, and then for I in S I will keep on adding. This will give me the output as this. This is giving me that the total characters are, I read the entire file using the read, okay, made a variable sum, and I went through the s, that is, I went through the string one character each and made a total. Now here, if you are told to find out if whether the contents or how many alphabets are there in the file, how many digits are there in the file, you can do it. If you remember, in the initial chapters, in the string lesson, we have done it. We all will use is alpha, is digit in this loop and find out number of alphabets, number of digits. In short, whenever you have to deal with a character, we usually use read function, read and keep it in string, and then all the functions of string can be used to manipulate or find out different characters. Okay. Now, if you are told to find out the number of lines which are present in this, let us see the code for this. This time I have used the function read lines. Read lines will read each of the line and make it as an element of a list. So I have kept it in the list, and then I have found out how many elements are there in the list will give me total number of lines that I have in the file. So lines done, characters for characters read, for lines read lines. You can also use read line for that. Now if I want to find out how many words are there in the file, again you can use read lines. I read the lines, got a list. Each element of the list is a string itself. That is, first element is the first string, second element is the second string, second element is the second line in the form of string. So each element I split it. Split means from empty places the words are derived, and the words are then kept in S. So what is S? S is one more list in which each word are there. And then I have counted how many elements are there in S, means how many words are there in the list S. Then I have added it. So it tells me that total number of words in the file are 8. I'll show you the file. So this is our file that we are using, myfile.txt. He says there are total 8 words in this. Let us see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 words are there. Clear? So this chapter is basically about how to use the methods given, and then you will be given a problem and you have to solve the problem either by using read, write, read lines or read line. So you need to know which one to use when. These are the various methods that we have in the file object class, and in that file object class we have close, we have flush. Flush will flush out the internal buffer. That is, if there is something remaining for you to read from the file, then all will be read at a go. We have not used next. It actually gives the next line from the file. You can try out on your own. Read, read line, read lines we have used. Seek also we have used, but we have not given an offset from when. Okay. It usually is the file's current position. You can change the position and then seek that many indexes after it. We have not used that also. We have used the simple form. Tell will tell you where your file pointer is at currently, and write will write a string. This is all for our file reading and writing when we are dealing with text file. Next we will be discussing about binary and CSV. Thank you.